Let's look for these bodies. Where could two dead bodies have disappeared to?
Damn.
We need to search for the bodies that have disappeared. What happens after that? Huh? The door must be locked. Dead bodies be. I don't know where they could be. Why are you just standing there? We need to get to the repository. You mean...
Indeed.
I found them. Hifumi and Taka's bodies have both been hidden in the repository.
Goodbye.
I already told Hina and Sakura, we'll go on ahead. Their bodies were in the repository. How did you guys open that door? What? Are the bodies here somewhere?
Hmm.
I have to wonder where they could have been hidden. Up ahead is the repository. The doorknob turned. I guess it's unlocked. I better not think twice about it and wonder why it was locked 5 seconds ago and now it's unlocked. So I opened the door, and when I entered, I saw... The two bodies that had disappeared were right there. The smell of blood made me gag, and what I saw before my eyes was unquestionable, unavoidable, unwavering reality. And then I heard the announcement for a second time.
A body has been discovered! After a certain amount of time, which you may use however you like, the class trial will begin!
And so, here we are.
It's the Monokuma File!
Without further ado, let me give you all the next Monokuma file. I was going to hand them out when you found the bodies the first time, but I thought something might happen.
What?
It was really hard to resist, but turns out I was right.
Stop talking.
Just hand it over already.
Punishment is waiting for you.
Now, make sure to investigate with all your mental might and prepare for the class trial.
See ya later!
Well then, now that we've found the bodies, all that's left is to uncover the culprit.
What the heck?
How can you be so calm? I mean, they're dead, you know?
That's terrible!
Dead? Gone forever? They're never coming back! Awful, this is all just too awful! Hina suddenly bursts into tears. She clutches at Hifumi's lifeless body.
this? Why? Why?
Large wet tears fell from her eyes. The tears landed on Hifumi's cheeks. If this were some world of make-believe, that might have been when Hifumi opened his eyes. But this wasn't a movie. This wasn't...
He's alive again?
Where am I? Cold. So cold. Is winter coming?
Hifumi! Wake up!
Huh? That's right. I remember now. Hope's Peak.
Come on, you gotta wake up!
I remember everything. Before I met you all. I met you all. Oh, the light. It's reaching out to me. Like the tail of a comet.
Hey, Hifumi! Who was it? Who attacked you? Who tried to kill you?
Who killed me? That's right. I remember. Their name. Yasu.
What?
Hero.
Oh damn, Hero. You just named Yasu Hero. His eyes closed, and they never opened again. Death for the second time. Absolute, undeniable death this time for no give me vaccines, never again, gonna die again. This time is 100% dead. We killed him just to make sure. No matter how many more of Hina's tears splashed his face, there was no second miracle. Reality set in again. This isn't some stereotypical fantasy world. Tears can't restore a person's vitality.
Honestly.
You have no tears, do you? No blood in your veins, no calcium in your bones. At least you have your meat.
Stop talking.
You're just angry. Going out of his way to return, just to leave us with those unnecessary dying words. Now this game has become exceedingly boring. You said Yasu Hero, right?
Then perhaps...
Yasuhiro Hagakure. That is the only person he could have been referring to.
So in other words...
And with that, the case is solved. Assaulting people and even killing Taka and Hifumi. And then going so far as to hide their body. A criminal that hides his face behind a mask and uses a bunch of giant wooden hammers. Is that what Hero is?
What is this?
If it's true, I can't forgive him. No way can I ever forgive him. To kill two of our friends.
That's fine.
Anyway, it's about time we track down the culprit in our little life or death game here. Although this time it's not all that life or death. The trial will conclude without much trouble.
Indeed.
It does look that way. It's going to begin again. We have to go through this one more time. I have to accept. I have no choice but to go through with this, to make sure everyone lives. I just have to do it. Investigation time. First, I better check the Monokuma file. The victims were Hifumi Yamada and Kiyotaka Ishimaru. The cause of death for each was a blow to the head. It is thought that they were both killed with a similar weapon. That's it?
Very strange.
Yeah, it's pretty strange. We got way less information this time than before. This is no problem. After all, the events of this case unfolded before our very eyes. We should know more about what happened than the Monokuma file could anyway. Maybe.
Well.
There's something else that's bothering me. Someone else has been missing for quite a while. Are you talking about Kyoko?
Perhaps.
Without a doubt, she has an alibi for when Celeste and Ifumi were attacked. But what if the killer wasn't acting alone? What if they had an accomplice? An accomplice? An accomplice? What are you doing here?
Monokuma appears!
Don't be rude. I'm here to answer your question. What question?
Yep.
You're talking about accomplices, right? I'm pretty sure I explained it before, didn't I? During the first class trial?
Speaking of which, I'd like to ask the bear. If there is an accomplice, do they also become blackened?
So you ask, and so I shall answer. Each murder is allowed to have an accomplice, but only the one who does the killing will get to graduate.
So in other words, two people can work together, but one of them has no chance of profiting from it.
Then there's no way anyone would work together, right?
In other words...
So basically, you can be an accomplice if you want, but there's no gratification in it.
So then...
So are you saying nobody works together this time, either?
Hey,
Sorry, can't answer that. It will obstruct the free exchange of information between you guys. I just want to make sure you don't forget, no matter how much you might assist in a murder.
Phew.
Only one black can graduate, an accomplice gets nothing.
So in other words...
Then we only need to figure out who that one blackened is that did the killing, right? Just like normal?
Well?
Okay, let me take this opportunity to clarify the whole shebang. In this class trial, what you need to determine is...
Extreme!
The one true blackened who devised the murder plot and put it into action. The true blackened, so just one person?
Well now.
That's enough for explaining. Now it's down to the final battle between all of you and the Blacken. Good luck to all the contestants. So there can only be one Blacken, an accomplice wouldn't benefit. Then I can't see any way Kyoko will be connected to the case after all. What do you mean? I can see a way that she could be connected to the case. So she wasn't there during the first attack. Well, I mean, like, she has an alibi for the first attack. But then everything that happened afterwards, like the second attack, the third attack, and the bodies being moved, she was missing for all of that. So she could, if she had an accomplice, then she could have, had an alibi for the first attack and then gone off to do all the other attacks and all the other destruction of evidence. Not saying Kyoko did it, but I don't see why he said that she wouldn't. You may be right. If that's true, then Kyoko, where are you?
However...
As long as she's not connected to the case, it doesn't matter. Let's get back to the investigation.
Indeed.
I have absolutely no doubt that Hiro is responsible. I bet you do, Celeste. But for the time being, I suppose it can't hurt to pursue further information.
So,
You know, don't you think we should consider a certain someone a suspect, just in case? I'm talking about the murderous fiend, Genocide Jack.
What?
I'm offended.
Ooh.
When did you? I've been looking all over you for you, Master. When I woke up, you were nowhere to be found.
You SOB!
You there, Milk Sack Swimmer Girl.
Huh?
Milk Sack?
You gotta be kidding.
Why do I gotta be a suspect? You are a serial killer.
What?
So I'm like a special guest suspect every time? I have an alibi, you know? She's right about that. When we heard Hifumi's scream, she was with me. And when the bodies disappeared, she was still lying unconscious in the equipment room. Taka's body aside, I can't imagine any way she would have been able to move Hifumi's body.
Yep.
I calculate every move I make. I'm not gonna kill someone when everyone knows what I look like. They don't call me murderous fiend for nothing.
What are you saying?
That's not the kind of thing you should be bragging about.
Let's see.
On another topic, should we post a guard by the bodies like before? We can't have them disappearing again.
So then...
Hina and I can handle that. You don't mind, do you, Hina? Sure, every toy is useless on the investigation anyway.
It's all clear now.
Then that's that. Let's begin. This whole thing is so strange. All of us have an alibi, so figuring out who did it should be obvious, right? But... maybe it's just me, but I don't think it's gonna be as straightforward as it seems. Alright, investigation time. But first...